Welcome back to part three. The fiasco continues. Things aren't looking good. We're going to do a quick time lapse. We're going to tear it back down, see if we can figure out what's going on with this thing. We're going to run a couple of basic tests, and we're going to show you all of the results. Now, there's a broken wire. Different. What we're going to do is we're going to take the compression hose, unscrew the adapter, and a Schrader valve tool, and we're going to go in here and we're going to take this Schrader valve right here out. You don't want to lose this because you're going to need to put it back in for future compression tests. Put the adapter back on. I've already got the engine turned by hand to get this cylinder up to top dead center compression stroke. Now listen very carefully. That's air coming by the intake valve. So we have a slightly kinked intake valve. And being that I don't have the capability at the moment to tear this all apart, we're going to put this back together and we're going to hopefully not burn up the valves and drive it this way. Let me know down in the comments below what you think about this. Thank you. we've got all of that junk back in. Let's put the alternator back in. Two bolts go down and through the bottom. Get those in and started. Those are 10 millimeter. Thanks. Sorry about that. He's an automotive shop instructor. All right, where'd that bracket go? I brought it out. Oh, here it is. Goofiest looking thing. And of course, it helps if I put it in right side up. There, but everything else. So it's right there, and then those three. Where did I put the three? There, there. These are 7 millimeter. What was it, 7 or 8? Yeah, these are 8. what I can see, we've got a bent valve on the intake number 5. It's only a slight kink. It wasn't giving enough compression to get past the Schrader valve in the compression tester, but there is a little compression there. It runs. Shy of pulling the head off on the side of the road, I'm not really sure what I'm going to do about it, but as far as I can see, I'm not going to really do any harm other than maybe burning up that valve if I continue to drive it. And being that this is my vehicle for getting around to do repairs on everybody else's vehicle, I've got to kind of drive it until I can figure out what I'm going to do with these heads. So until then, you have a good evening. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Down in the comments, let me know what you think about all of this. And don't forget, you got no more excuses. That may be this one. Pick up those wrenches.